Inspiration can often lead to some harebrained schemes, like the crazy notion that man could fly. But as we know, crazy notions can often turn out to be strokes of genius.
I love it when people say they can't believe this hasn't been done before. You just know it must be a brilliant idea.
And I guess the breakthrough came when that group of people came to ask you for the sewing machine, Tony.
Yes, and do you remember what happened back in the UK?
We started an appeal.
We had an appeal and the response was so great. We had hundreds and hundreds of people fetch the sewing machines out of their lofts and presented them to us.
So I guess we've got to remember that Chilimone is a particularly deprived township in what must be one of the world's poorest countries.
Oh, yes. That's
Malawi,
sure.
My goodness. Sure. And in the region, a school feeding program had been established. And mothers were sending their children, their starving children, to school, not only for a good education, but also for a meal that they ate. Mm. And what a great good education is in the fight against poverty.
Yes.
I want a girl. Yes, you?
Chilimone is like so many deprived communities where things have gone so obviously wrong for such a long time, and it pulls at your heartstrings and you want to help. And the first thing that springs to mind very often in these situations is, well, what can we send? And maybe that's food or aid of different kinds. But you know, you're going down the same route of needing to rattle tins forever and to evoke sympathy and just give and give. And
well, there are situations where that's needed, all emergency situations, but this isn't an emergency situation.
No, you're quite right. Quite right. Those situations are there. But the exciting thing about the Beehive is that it builds a creative human culture that enables community to provide for itself, so that eventually that giving is no longer needed, and it becomes self-reliant and sustainable.
Yeah. Well, I suppose what we're really doing is just the old adage, give a man a fish and he eats for a day, but teach a man how to fish and he feeds his family for a lifetime, and that's
exactly right. Yeah.
So how does it work, and how did you get there?
Well, you know how it is these days, with so many requests from charities, people being asked for things from so many different angles. People are just tired of being asked for money. And we started to ask ourselves, well, what can we do differently? And how can we address this problem in Chilimone Township in a different way?
So we actually managed to fill a 40-foot container with these second-hand sewing machines.
Wow.
40 foot.
And that was the start of the Beehive Tailoring School, which by now we've seen nearly 2,000 people receive training. Yeah. And so, do you remember, we thought, well, what else is there in people's lofts? You know, things that are heading for landfill.
That's right. Yes.
Books,
throwing away.
Bikes, computers, a whole host of things.
Yeah.
And it became the start of jobs that were transforming lives in Chilimone Township.
A completely different kind of charity.
Vince, tell me about the bicycles, Beebikes.
Mm. Well, it's very interesting because people can make a big mistake in believing that handouts, just giving things away, is the best way to help. But Beebikes works quite differently. In Chilimone, a bicycle set the buyer back anything from £20 to £60, but the average income in Chilimone is about £10 a month. So you can see it's no small outlay, but it's got a number of advantages. Firstly, it gives the buyer something to aspire to, a purpose. Secondly, it becomes the family vehicle, and in most cases, it transforms their lives. But more importantly, the money generated will pay the wages of the staff at Beebikes, as well as funding other projects. And this means that the original donation of a bicycle has effectively been multiplied many, many times. And this is one of the main secrets of the Beehive's success.
So, by using the principle of collecting unwanted or obsolete equipment from the UK, then selling it or using it as part of a new business in Chilimone, the Beehive has not only become the biggest employer in Chilimone, but has stimulated business across a much broader area. And, although still comparatively poor, because of the Beehive, people living in Chilimoni are now living with some hope, a chance to actually earn a living, and the prospect of their children, in turn, to be able to develop their own skills and benefit from the fruits of their own labour. And this will be achieved either through working directly for or in connection with the Beehive model of social enterprise.
So what do you do then?
We rent out computers at a very cheap price to entrepreneurs.
I'm enjoying now because yeah. I've got my own monies. My kids are able to go to school because I'm working, and my life has changed.
We didn't expect this project to come to Chilimoni, but in the way you people in UK, what you have done for us by bringing this project to Chilimoni, we really appreciate. British bicycles, they're very strong.
So the British bikes are better than the bikes in Atlanta?
Yeah. I would like to appeal to our friends in UK. At least, if you have a standing bicycle in your house, which is not on use, can you please throw it to us? We are going to make use of that bicycle.
And Alfred's new business became possible when someone donated a power drill.
So what's the main thing that you've learned during the last 5 years, guys?
Yeah, well, that's a good one. I don't know if it's the main thing, but certainly one of the early lessons we learned was how limited are our own skills and how we needed help and support from skilled people.
Yes.
So we've managed to attract a whole range of volunteers, architects, engineers, IT consultants, people who've been willing to give up their time for 3 months, 6 months, a length of period which has been really useful. So the thing that's been valuable about the Beehive is the bees, really. The busy bees who are Malawian staff and volunteers from this country, from the UK, from Italy, from South Africa. We've had a whole range of people who've been willing to sacrifice of themselves, to give of their time, their skills and energy and effort and contribute.
It's challenging, I have to say, because the classes are large. We have about 80 or 90 in a class. And our resource is basically a blackboard and some chalk. So that's sort of the first obstacles to overcome.
And as Jennifer says, the children are a delight. They're not all well behaved, just as in England, but they do have a passion to learn, and that really comes through. They do want to learn.
I guess one of the great things is now that we've built, using our own Beehive bricks and Beehive staff, we've built a volunteer centre where the volunteers are accommodated and fed, and they enjoy a reasonable stay. It was certainly different in the early days. It was hard work and a bit rough and tough. But now there's a better environment. We've got a more structured approach to the recruitment, a better idea of what we're looking for, and the kind of people who will get the most out of the experience and be able to give of themselves. So, you know, these guys are able to provide a sort of a blueprint for a viable business in Africa. And they come over and help with that.
We are transforming a community, completely transforming a community.
So today we have 12 enterprises in the Beehive Centre for Social Enterprise. And some of them, in terms of the income they generate, stand head and shoulders above the others. The Torrance plant and vehicle hire operation now generates in excess of £50,000 every month. It's much needed income. It enables us to have a locally generated fund that can start new enterprises, and so it's self-regenerating. And it also enables us to have locally generated funds that give us money for children, vulnerable children and orphans, to go into the Beehive Children's Centre.
When David and I walk to work, we see children playing in the street. We see children sitting in the drains sometimes where water is trickling down, and mixing clay and then moulding toys.
Anything like musical instruments, footballs, netballs, wooden jigsaw puzzles, good quality educational toys are really sought after here.
And black dolls as well, and small world toys with black
also,
characters.
Also things like magnets and scissors, which we take for granted in the UK. you just can't get hold of here. You're more than welcome to pay us a visit out here in Malawi anytime you'd like to come.
Yeah.
See you all soon, baking in the sun here.
So the beehive is buzzing. The beehive is making honey and is doing really, really well. And long may it continue.